Hello there everybody, it is me Freezer Bunny and welcome back to another Sims 4 house building video. And I'm really excited to welcome you guys back here in Willow Creek, where we are going to be building one of my favorite homes ever in the whole entire world. Yes you guys, today we're going to be building the Sims 4 version of Downton Abbey. Now notice I said the Sims 4 version of Downton Abbey. It's because that, you know, the Sims 4 does come with a lot of limitations and it is impossible to recreate any house from real life and recreate it 100% in any of the Sims games. So that's why I just want to be clear that I'm gonna try my best to recreate the whole effect and to be true to the design of the house and hopefully do it justice. And just really quickly, if you guys don't know what Downton Abbey is, it is the setting for one of the most popular dramas ever in the whole entire world. It is the of course, it is the setting for the drama of Downton Abbey, and you know, it is basically the story is about a house pretty much, and all the people who live inside the house, not just the owners of the house, actually the people who also work in the house, and pretty much how they struggle with real life and all that good stuff in the early 1900s. So it's a very interesting story, and I highly recommend it if you guys haven't seen it yet. It's just one of my obsessions, I guess. But anyway, so I'm gonna try my best to be as faithful to the floor plan of Downton Abbey, otherwise known as Highclere Castle, by the way. Downton Abbey is the fictional name of this house, but since I'm gonna be focusing more on the aspects of Downton Abbey, the drama, this video is gonna be called like the Downton Abbey series. I just want to be clear about that. Anyway, let's just plop in a room here really quickly and start off with the very first room, which is gonna be the foyer. And I think it's actually gonna be, I'm not so sure how big it's gonna be though. Maybe it's gonna be like six tiles. You know what, let's make it 8 tiles, I guess. Just want to make sure that that's like 8 tiles. 2, 4, 6, 8. And I am looking at the floor plans, you guys, of the actual Downton Abbey itself. It's here in my phone, just to be more you know, just to be more truthful to the design of the house. So yeah, anyway, I'm actually doing this because I had a lot of positive feedback with my other videos, especially my real-time house building ones, so I'm hoping that you guys will also like this series as well. Okay, so according to the floor plan that I'm looking at, this is the main foyer, 2, 4, 6, 8. I'm just really iffy about making sure that all the rooms are like properly dimensioned and stuff like that, but anyway, let's see. Okay, so this room, it says, is gonna be like the library extension and stuff like that, which if you guys watch the drama is a very important place because like a lot of things happen here. So it's probably gonna be, you know what, let's undo that. I want to base the plan of it on the windows actually, so I'm doing this just to see like I guess the windows of the house, and yep, maybe just one more, I guess. Okay, I guess that's fine. Okay, and oh, we also need to include like one of those tower things, I guess. So let's add one of those. I want it to be 3x3 tiles. Okay, that's good. Okay, so how many tiles is this? Never mind. How many tiles is that? I'm like, I really miss the Sims 3 and the ability to like, I don't know, I don't know what it's called, like the counter, I guess, on how many floors or wall tiles you're placing. I really miss that aspect, but whatever. We have the price anyway, so I'm just basing the measurements on that. But yes, you guys, as I mentioned earlier, Downton Abbey is like literally one of my favorite TV series of all time, you know. I think it just has an amazing storyline. Oh, and it actually has like some interesting place over here. So let's add like a nice little area over here where the wall becomes like that. And we can even probably just place like some of those. Yeah, it's nice. I like that. So yes, anyway, you guys, yeah, it's literally like one of my favorite TV series of all time, and it has such an amazing story that, you know, the second I watched season 1 way back in 2012, I was hooked. And yes, I said 2012 because it actually airs later here in my country. I think they first showed it around 2011 or 2012, and I'm like, okay, I can't stop. And during that time, there were only two seasons, and I'm like, okay, the second I watched season one, I was like, oh my god, I need to watch the next freaking season. So I'm like, okay. I just watch it online pretty much. So I'm actually, okay, I'm just gonna make this room smaller here, I guess. Okay, let's see here. So in case you guys didn't know, every time I do these kinds of videos, I usually try to like figure it out as I go, you know. So there's gonna be a lot of like modifications and alterations and all that stuff. So that's it for me. Okay, I guess that's gonna be it. Maybe like that. Okay, it looks nice, I guess. Or yeah, I guess it looks nice. I think the rooms are a little bit big though, so I'm thinking maybe I'm gonna make them smaller. Let me just delete these ones, and then yeah, I feel like they're a little bit big. So okay, let me just diminish this by 2 tiles each on each room, I guess. Let's see here. It's also quite long as well, so I'm not so sure. Anyway, so and I'm also gonna diminish this by 2 tiles. Diminish, you guys. Anyway, fancy here with the words and stuff. Anyway, so yeah, like I've said, the story of Downton Abbey really revolves around the Crawley family, or the family that owns the Abbey itself. And basically the premise of the series is that the Titanic sank, which is, you know, features prominently in the first series, and then they don't have an heir pretty much. So because they don't have, the family doesn't have a male heir, so their wealth, all their money is gonna go to a person who they don't know. So yeah, it's basically gonna revolve around that kind of storyline where, you know, people who don't know a certain someone are gonna be giving their money. And yeah, it's basically all about money and stuff like that. So really, really interesting. And Maggie Smith is absolutely fabulous in the drama. She is friggin' hilarious. I love her so much. I loved her so much in friggin' Harry Potter. And I don't know, I think she literally makes the drama, you know, you guys. Anyway, so this room, it is called, like, I'm not so sure what this room is called though. I don't know. The floor plan that I'm looking at does not have any labels, so I'm just gonna make that like that, I guess. Really, really small. And then this is gonna be kind of good, like, yeah, the drawing room. Maybe you can make it like that, I guess. Yep. Okay, that's fine. And then this is where the tricky bit comes in, because there's actually, like I've said, we cannot recreate everything, you know, brick by brick in The Sims 4. Or in any sim game, actually. I'm gonna be truthful to you guys about that. So I'm gonna try to improvise here, because a lot of the story of Downton actually revolves around the fact that there is a huge separation between the servants and their masters, and that is reflected in the house itself. So you guys could probably guess that the house plays a big part, because the servants, they actually live underground. They live downstairs, or like most of what they do happens downstairs, below their master. So that's kind of like a hierarchical way of viewing things, and it's really, really interesting. So those are gonna be the 4 towers. And of course, I'm putting my own spin on things, you guys. You know, usually based on the actual floor plan itself, the tower, only 3 towers are actually kind of symmetrical. The other one is like over here. Yeah, looking at it now, it's like way, way over here, which we do not have any room for. So yeah, obviously I'm just trying to improvise as much as I can, and in order to make a good iteration, I guess, of Downton Abbey in The Sims 4. So I'm gonna do my best, and you guys can definitely count on that. But anyway, so yeah, let me just center the lot here really quickly. Okay, that is 100, and this is, ooh, it's also 100. Okay, let's make it like that. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 8. That's 8. Okay, so anyway, you guys could probably also guess that I'm like freaking obsessed with symmetry, and I don't know, I'm just freaking obsessed, you guys. I'm like, just whoa. Anyway, I'm just gonna place it there, I guess. I love this feature in The Sims 4, you know, the fact that you can just transfer your homes. You don't even have to demolish everything. I think that's so awesome. I love how they thought of that. It makes life so much more easier, you know, in The Sims 4. In The Sims 3 below, you know, you had to demolish everything. If you accidentally built your lot like one tile off center, you literally had to build everything. So, you know, I like how in The Sims 4 it gives you a little bit more room to just try to experiment and, you know, just be the best that you can be without wasting so much time, I guess. And I really, really like that. So yes, anyway, so this tower, I think there's actually like a room over here or something, I don't know. There is like some sort of room over there though, so yeah. I think I'm probably just gonna place, not so sure, maybe a room here like that. Then this can probably be a hallway-ish or something. I don't know, I'm not gonna try to like recreate everything in the drama like 100%, but I'm gonna try my best to be, you know, to be as accurate, I guess. Anyway, let me just look. Okay, that's 44, and then this is 44 as well. Okay, we're like literally losing space, so I'm not so sure. Let's see here. Okay, so some of this area, I guess it's gonna be probably, yeah, probably the kitchens are gonna be here, I guess, since there's no downstairs, you know. The kitchens are probably gonna be in this area-ish. Yeah, I'm not so sure. I'm still thinking, you guys. It's not like set in stone, you know, what we need to do here. I'm like, okay, I'm flexible, I guess. Anyway, so yeah, it's gonna be like that. And then I want to split it down the middle. Oh my god, are you kidding me? There's no middle. I'm like, okay, oops, never mind. So in Downton Abbey, there is like a room for the staff where they eat, I guess, for all the servants where they eat. And then there's also, of course, a kitchen, which, of course, every house has to have one. So I feel like I'm probably going to extend this over there. And then I'm gonna place, this is gonna be the kitchen, and then that's probably gonna be the staff dining room or something along the lines of that. I'm not so sure. I just wanna make sure that these are like the same size though, so. So yeah, basically Downton Abbey, there's a lot of things going on with the servants actually. There's a lot of drama involving the servants. And 2, 4, 6, 7. Okay, and there's, yeah, like I said, there's a lot of drama involving the servants and all that stuff. But since, you know, we really couldn't have any servants in The Sims 4, I'm like probably not gonna focus on them that much. Just because I guess I'm just gonna focus on something else, you know, of course. Yeah. So, there's probably not even gonna be a servant's quarters, you know. I'm not even gonna bother placing rooms for the maids and all that stuff, just because, do we really need to place those? I don't feel like we need to, so, yeah. Anyway, so, let's see here. 2, 4, 6. I feel like the house is like super huge. I don't know. Is it just me? I don't know. I'm sure. I'm like really not so sure though. So let's see here. I'm just looking at things and just, I don't know, you guys. I'm like spacing out, I guess. I don't know. We can probably just, you know, do something about the house later on. You know, if I'm not happy with something, I can always change it, I guess. But so far, it doesn't look so bad, does it? I mean, yes, it looks nice, actually. So, yeah. You know what? I could probably even, like, put some sort of room over here, I guess. Oops. I'm not so sure. See here, let's make it like a 6 by something, 2, 4, 3, 6, yeah. Maybe like that, I don't know. It's really, really cramped now, I guess. Maybe just here, I guess. I'm like making this up, you guys, as we go. I'm like, I don't know, I don't know. This is probably gonna be like the kitchen, I guess. 6? I guess that's big enough to be the kitchen. This can be like the staff dining room, which is surprisingly quite small. And yeah, it's a little bit small, but we'll figure it out, I guess. And I could probably extend it or something. I don't know. I'll figure it out. And I'm also considering placing like a nice little garden here. That's just my own personal touch, I guess, to this downtown, to this version of downtown that we have. But anyway, okay. I just want to mark out the tower. The castle itself, Highclere Castle, aka Downton Abbey in real life. Anyway, let me just make things clear for you guys. The real name of Downton Abbey is Highclere Castle, okay? So if I say Highclere Castle or Downton Abbey, I pretty much mean both of them the exact same thing. So yeah. Anywho, let me just build that there and then just remove the floor. Okay, it's there, so let me just click on that, and then okay, like that. Is that like 8x8? Okay. Let me just trace that upstairs as well. So that's gonna be our tower. And yeah. This is gonna be the main house. Let's see here. Like that. Yeah, like that, I think. And then this is gonna be like the servants' quarters. So it's gonna be a little bit lopsided on one side, which is okay for me, you know. I mean, I guess too much symmetry is like a bad thing, I guess. So I usually throw like, you know, some curveballs, I guess, to my own design and the way I design things. But anyway, so that is gonna be the towers as well. Unfortunately, in The Sims 4, we can only go as high up as 3 floors. So this is gonna be really, really tricky when the base of Downton Abbey is already 3 floors. And then we have like 5 towers like radiating from it, and like I'm not so sure how to do this. I was really, really reluctant to actually do this build because I was like, I don't feel like I can do justice to such a building. But you know what, I'm gonna do my best. I'm gonna do absolutely my very, very best. We're gonna see, you know, we're gonna see where this takes us. Anyway, I think this is gonna be interesting anyway, so yeah. So that's how it's gonna look like for now, and then I guess we're just gonna be placing some towers over here as well. Okay, let's see here. That's nice. Okay, I like that. And then I guess we could just play with the height of the rooms for now. I guess I want to make it like as high as possible because Downton Abbey is a really, really tall building. So yeah, I guess that's good actually. I really, really like how it looks so far. Next thing that I want to do is probably do something about this because this is kind of just creepy. I'm not so sure. Let's see here. Do we even need this room? I don't think we do. Let's delete that. And then it can be a nice little T shape, I guess, would be interesting. Would it be? I don't know. It's a little bit, it looks weird. I guess I'm just gonna keep that out of the room. Like that, and then let's see here. This is giving me such a difficult time. I guess we can, I don't know. I honestly don't know. But so far, I really like the layout of it so far. Anyway, let's just go on with the painting anyway. I feel like I know what kind of paint I want, and I really want this one. Because, I don't know, it's the same, it's almost the same color as Downton. You know, Downton Abbey has this yellowish stone. You know what, I do want to look for something that has like moldings, or something that has trims actually would be really cool. I hope it comes in like our color. No, that's too yellow. This one? I've used this a lot in my Villa Capra series, and I'm like, okay, never mind. And then, oh my god. 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 Probably this one. Okay, that's nice, actually. I like that. And I like how it has, like, the stone. I like how it has the stone as well. I think that's really interesting. You guys can see the stone trimmings on the lower part of the wall. Really, really, really cool. So yeah, this looks like it's a very similar color to Downton. You know, we can always change it later on. I wish we had the option in The Sims 4 to have, like, we can literally paint the whole entire house. I hope they include it in, like, a future patch because, yeah. I just want to be able to click on something and, yeah. I also want to put like some of these things. I think these would be really cool, you know. Anyway, I guess we're just gonna be placing some windows now. So Downton has like some rectangular windows, just really, really square windows. Maybe these ones look nice. That actually looks really, really nice. Ah, that looks so nice. But I don't think I'm gonna go with those because they have the shutters, which is so not Downton. That's too small. Maybe in the two floors. I'm like, oh, it's freaking 3x3. I'm used to The Sims 2 when everything, or The Sims 3 where everything was like based on the number 2. The Sims 4, we have a little bit more variety, you know. You know what? I'm gonna go with that. That looks lovely, actually. Looks gorgeous. I love that. And then we're also gonna put one series of windows over there. That's nice. I like that. Oops. I like this a lot. And then I think I can actually put some of those columns. I think they actually attach to the, oops. They attach to the wall, I'm guessing. And Downton has some really interesting details as well. So, what do you guys think of that? That looks nice, actually. It looks really, really nice. Maybe with a different one, it would look a little bit better. Let's see here. And I just really want to tell you guys that I have a sore in my mouth. And I'm like, it's really, really painful every time I open my mouth, let alone to eat. You know, I'm like, oh my god, it's so freaking painful. I'm not so sure how you guys say it in English, though, but yeah, I have a sore in my mouth. And one more really interesting story that I wanted to say to you guys, that I want to tell you guys, is that there's another typhoon, pretty much. So it happened on Friday and on Saturday, so classes has been canceled, like, for the third consecutive time, you know, because we are experiencing the second typhoon this week, you guys. I'm like, whew, can you give us a break, please? Like, seriously. So I really wanted to get this to you guys as soon as possible, but I wasn't able to do so because my friends actually had to stay over because they were stuck. You know, there was a huge flood outside and it was literally waist high and stuff like that in some areas, so they could literally not go home. And I was like, why don't you just stay over? You know, my house is near our school. And so basically they were stuck here for 2 days, from Thursday, Friday until Saturday, pretty much. They just left now, so I can record freely. But I just wanted to let you guys know that, whew, very, very difficult times here. But I'm fine, you know, they have electricity now. We have electricity now, and, you know, all is well, all is good, I guess. Let me just place a foundation here anyway. Like that. Very, very shallow foundation, I guess. Ooh, I actually think we can put some of those, like, something that has this type of detail underneath it would be really cool, you know. I think it would look lovely. Let's see here. Does it come in our colors? No, it doesn't. It doesn't come in our colors, you guys. I'm so sad now. I'm like, it would look so gorgeous, though. Like that. Oh my god. That would look so amazing. I wish it would come in, like, a matching color with our wall. I think that would be so freaking amazing. It would literally piss my pants if I found, like, a matching type. But I don't think so. So I think I'm just gonna be placing these ones. Yeah, I guess that's nice, I guess. You know, it's not necessarily 100% the same as our walls. But, you know, they kind of work, you know. I don't think they're that bad, I guess. It does make our wall look like it's having a seizure because it doesn't know what color it's going to be in. Yeah, but that looks kind of nice. Yeah, I like that. I'm just looking at other... oh my god, oh my freaking god, oh my god, you guys, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, this is literally the same color as our wall, isn't it? Oh my god, yes it is, yes, 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 oh yes, I love that, that is so freaking amazing. I'm like, ah, somebody pinch me, this is too good. This one, I'm just testing out some things. Oh my god, this one also matches. Which one do you guys think? I feel like I like the second one better. I don't know. It just looks more interesting like that. I don't know. I like that a lot. Yes, yes, yes. I'm happy now. I'm like, okay, thank god I found these walls, though. Oh, you know what? I also think that we should change these windows as well, you know, into something that's more, I guess something that's more, I don't know, smaller or something. I don't know what the word that I'm trying to be. This is cool. Oh, this would have been so freaking gorgeous though. I'm like, I don't know. I just want to put some smaller windows. It's nice, I guess. I don't know. I'm not feeling it. Maybe this one, if it comes in our color. Okay, it does come in our colors, and okay, I love that. It looks really, really good like that. So I'm really happy. Yeah. Now I'm glad that, yeah, I'm really happy with how it turned out. So anyway, let's just put these ones as well. I guess they're gonna be like the faux balconies that we have in Downton. You know, there's a lot of like detail. If you really look close into the house itself, you would really discover some really interesting details and stuff like that. So you guys can probably see that I'm leaving this part here blank because something interesting is happening here with like all the turrets and stuff like that. Really, really interesting. Highclere Castle, or the real Downton Abbey, was actually designed by the person who also designed the Houses of Parliament in London, which is, for me, one of the most iconic buildings in the UK. You know, it's like Big Ben, you know, it's very, very, very similar design to Downton, where it's very gothic and all that good stuff. So yeah, just a little bit of trivia for you guys, and I just wanted to let you guys know that I really do my research on this type of thing, and yeah. Oh my god, I totally forgot that we should be probably placing some trims, actually. We should be placing, like, some friezes or something. Oh my god, no. No. Okay, it works like that, I guess. For the upper parts, I think those looks nice. Looks really, really nice. Yes, I like that. Yes, yes, yes. And I think I'm actually even going to be placing some over there as well. So let's do that now. And then over here as well for the... Yeah, that works. And I think... I don't know. We're probably just going to leave that blank because you guys can see that it's kind of covering the windows. If I place that, would it delete the window? Oh, yeah, it deleted the window. So you know what? Nope. Oh, we can probably even use these ones. Oh, that looks lovely. That looks amazing. I love that. I'm like, whoa. Seriously, though, you guys, I'm like, whoa. I'm like super excited. I can't believe I'm building freaking Downton Abbey in freaking The Sims 4. I'm like just overwhelmed right now. I'm like, a couple of weeks ago when I first did the Trianon Palace, I'm like, okay, I really want to build Downton Abbey, but, you know, I really kind of needed that push, I guess. So the success of the two houses that I did really pushed me to do something that I was really passionate about. Something that I really loved and shared with you guys. And, you know, I'm doing it right now and I'm just really, really happy that I, you know, that I forced myself to do it. Because before I decided to film this, I'm like, I was really not sure because I felt like I would not be able to do justice to Downton Abbey, especially with The Sims 4 being very limited. But now, you know, seeing what I can do, I feel a little bit more optimistic, to be completely honest with you guys. So yeah. And there's a lot of really interesting things in The Sims 4 as well. So yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying yourself so far. And ooh, what is that? Oh, okay. I'm like, there's probably like a wall blocking it or something. Yeah, it is. Okay, let me just probably drag that like that. Yeah, that kind of works. And then that room is really small though. So, and then let's just do the upper part as well. This side of the facade is actually probably the part where you can see the facade in its full detail. You know, in other sides, it's kind of obstructed. You don't see the whole wing. You know, there's things blocking it, but this one, you can really see it in its glory. And I'm really, really happy that it looks absolutely stunning. I'm like, whoa. Actually, I'm also thinking of probably, you know, let me just place that there. And then over here as well. Like that, and then like that as well. Okay, and let me just grab that paint. I also feel like I'm losing my voice here, guys. I'm just trying my best to be entertaining and all that stuff. Okay, let's see here. Let's talk a little bit about Downton Abbey here. Probably my favorite episode would be episode 1 of the whole entire thing. You know, the part where Charlie Cox was in it and he was together with, spoilers here, you guys, and he was like in a relationship with one of the footmen. Yes, you guys, freaking footmen. Thomas was his name, and they were like in a gay relationship with each other, which really, really shocked me. Oh my god, I'm like, whoa, are they freaking kidding me? They really pulled out the guns, you know. Episode 1 was like so freaking epic. I'm like, and then the other episode that I really liked was episode 3 of season 1, where Mary and about Mr. Pamuk, and he actually died in her bed. I'm like, I'm telling you guys the truth here. He freaking died in her bed. I'm like, whoa, that was just so unexpected. And I'm like, I was kind of like seriously amazed by the creativity of the writer, Julian Fellowes. Very, very creative. And probably another favorite episode of mine is like the wedding of Mary and Matthew was also a really good episode. Oh, there's a lot of really good things. So if you guys haven't watched Downton Abbey, please give it a chance. It is such an amazing drama. I highly recommend it to you guys. It's, you know, please give it a try. You know, give it a shot. You know, I'm pretty sure you guys will like it. Anyway, what I discovered is actually that your Sims can walk up the step here, so you don't need to place some stairs. They can actually like walk up like that, so it's really, really cool as well. And I also really want to probably just change the color of the swing here. I don't know, just to give it a little bit of separation for the rest of the house. So I'm thinking of probably making it like a brick color or something. Let's try to make it a nice brick. I don't know, I feel like brick says like servant swing so strongly. You know, the swing is not for the master of the house, it is for the freaking servants. And yeah, that's really nice. I like that. You know, so rather than using the basement as kind of like the division between master and servant, I'm just using this area as like, you know, change the color of it and all that stuff. Really, really cool. Okay, let's see here. What else do we need to do? I feel like I need to place the roof now before things get complicated. So let me just place, you know what, let me place like those windows first, I guess. So the towers also have square windows, really, really interesting ones as well. I think I'm gonna use this one. Please be okay, there we go. That works really well. And in case you guys have not noticed, I'm literally obsessed with period dramas. I love watching Jane Austen dramas, like Pride and Prejudice. I feel like I've watched all the versions of it. Let's see, what else do I like to watch? Pride and Prejudice, Emma, Sense and Sensibility was a really good one. Some people who acted in Downton Abbey were actually in Sense and Sensibility. So I'm like, obviously friggin' fanboying over here, you guys. I'm like, whoa, somebody stop me. Somebody like, nobody can put on the brakes or something. Anyway, that looks freaking awesome. I'm really, really happy with how it looks so far. Let me just place everything like that. Anyway, I had a lot of fun with my friends here. You know, we watched a lot of horror movies and stuff like that. That's probably why I'm losing my voice, because I'm like too busy screaming and stuff like that. But anyway, I hope you guys had a great weekend though. This is probably gonna be up on a Saturday or a Sunday. I'm not so sure. Depends on the internet speed. So yeah, I can't wait for you guys to see this, because it's a really, really popular house, and you know, I know that a lot of you guys will be interested, and I hope that by doing this, I was able to get you guys interested in Downton Abbey as well. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna try my best to do justice to it. Okay, next thing that I want to do is that there's actually some interesting columns over here on the side, and those are just square columns though, so I'm just probably gonna go, no, that's too bright. This one? Yep, I think that's nice actually. Why can't I place it? Okay, there we go. For some reason though, you can't see it that well. You know what? Never mind, let's change it. What else? Columns do we have? This one is also square. Yay! And that looks gorgeous. I love it. It feels like a little bit modern though. I'm not so sure. Maybe this one if it comes in our colors. You know what? That one looks a lot like the picture, actually. That one looks like a lot like what they have in Downton. So I actually really like this column. So yeah, let's keep it like that. It's also very, very, you know, it's not something that you would normally expect from me, you guys. It looks really retro, you know? So I'm really just trying to get out of my comfort zone to give you guys an amazing home here. So yes. I love the effect that it gives the house, though. I'm like, whoa! Yes, yes, yes. I feel like I'm even gonna place, like, for some reason, my game is also, like, fluctuating. I don't know why. But, yeah, it's probably because it's been a couple of days since I've last played The Sims 4, so I think my laptop's getting used to it. But, anyway, let's see here. So, yeah, it's a very, very interesting house, you guys. It's very grand, but at the same time, if you step inside of it, it's very intimate, actually. You know, you would never expect this house to feel so homey and so welcoming by seeing just the exterior. So I think the architect and the interior designers did an amazing job with this house. It's definitely one of the most spectacular homes out there, so. Anyway, okay, let's see here. Let's do that as well. And then, like that. Like that. And, it's really, really tricky as well, you know? I wish it would, like, understand what I'm trying to do here. But, yeah. It works. It's gonna work, you know? I hope some glitches get fixed with the patches, you know? So, because so far The Sims 4 is really glitchy and it does lack a lot of features that I wish would have been included, but whatever, you know, I'm pretty sure expansion packs and patches will be able to do something about that, I guess. But anyway, so yeah, that's that. And let me just take a sip of water here, guys, because I feel like I've been talking for forever. Awesome. I'm glad I have like a glass of water next to me, because if I talk too much, my sore gets really, really painful and kind of just hurts a lot, I guess. Okay, so let me just do you know what? I feel like the tower is kind of gigantic, so I'm just gonna make it a little bit smaller, maybe by 2 tiles, just so I'm like able to be correct with the proportions. I think proportionally that's so much better. So let's just put the windows, of course, like that. You know what? I'm even thinking of placing like different windows as well. You know, maybe round ones would look interesting. What do you guys think? I think round windows would make it look interesting. You know, even though that's like not how they have it in real life, I think it would look really interesting. I feel like I've said the word interesting like a million times in that one sentence, but anyway. And I really like, what I also really like about The Sims 4 is that it has these trims, which are absolutely gorgeous. You know, I've been really missing them in The Sims 3 because, I don't know, The Sims 3, the trims were quite different from what we have in The Sims 4, and I can honestly say that The Sims 4 ones are freaking so much better. They're just kind of amazing. Okay, if we can find a nice little round window, that would be amazing. And I hope it comes. Yes, it could. Oh my god, it's freaking puny. Okay, this one is so much more larger, actually. Oh my god, I love that. That looks gorge, actually, you guys. It looks freaking gorgeous, even though that's not how they have this in real life. I think I'm gonna go with it, actually. You know, why not? Just be different, you know? And yeah, I like the other one. Very kind of reminds me of steampunk for some strange reason. I don't know, just very steampunk looking type of thing. But anyway, yeah, I'm gonna keep it like that. And the next thing that we're gonna do is actually we're gonna be placing the roofs, which is gonna be really interesting because I feel like the roof is not gonna be, it's gonna be really complicated. Okay, there we go. Place place that there. And then let's see here. Let's place that like. No. Oh no. I think it's gonna get rid of. Yes, it got rid of the columns that we had. You know what? Let's just. I guess we can spare some space so that we can keep the column. How about over here though? How are we gonna place a roof over there? I'm like. Yeah. I'm kind of like. Okay, yeah, it's kind of spoiling my excitement here, I guess. But anyway, we'll figure things out, you know. Part of the way I build in the Sims series is just, I have to just, you know, I just really make do with what I have in the game. You know, I don't mod my game. I don't download a lot of custom content because I just really try my best to do with what I have. You know, we need to be creative and we need to be inventive as well with what we do. So we'll figure it out, you guys. We'll figure it out. I promise we will. But anyway, we're gonna place that there as well. Just trying to avoid these columns, I guess, so that they don't disappear. Yeah, they really do disappear. So we're probably gonna be placing like a fence over those or something. I don't know. And of course, Downton looks like it has a flat roof, but I think in reality it actually has a roof that's very similar to this. We are going to adjust the pitch of the roof though, just to make it a little bit more, to make it pretty much invisible, you know. I want it to look like a flat roof, and yeah. So it's gonna be like that, and then this is gonna be like that, of course. Pretty much gonna be the same thing for all the roofs, and like that as well. And I also want to thank you guys a lot for the tips that you guys gave me. You guys gave me a lot of tips in order to have better gameplay in The Sims 4. And thank you so much to everyone who commented in my other videos. And okay, let's just put that there to put like a barrier, I guess, like that. Really, really nice. I'm not even gonna bother changing the tiles there because I'm pretty sure nobody can even see them. Normally, actually, you guys, let me just explain. This area is actually taller than the rest of the towers here, but since this is literally the highest we can build in The Sims 4, there's pretty much no way around it, I guess. You know, there's not even any cheats that I can work with, so. No move objects, no freaking constraint floor elevation, so we're just gonna have to make do with what we have, actually. And I totally forgot to place, like, a molding over here. No, it doesn't come in a brick one, aww. You know what, why not make it black? Let's just make it black, you know, and let's change the tiles. I mean, let's change the brick to black as well. I do hope that it comes in a black. Yes, it does, I guess. This is really nice. What do you guys think about that? That's, yeah. I'm not so sure. This one has a really good texture though, so I think I'm gonna go with this one. Yeah, I like the texture of that a lot, and yeah, I guess it actually works, you know. I think it's fine, you know. It's the servant, they don't need luxury, they don't need a beautiful house, they just need to be able to work in the house. And I totally just like slapped my microphone and it fell over. Thankfully it didn't break, but anyway. Should probably just edit that out. You guys are probably like, he is such a psycho. You know, I had very little sleep since last night because, like I've said, there's a calamity in my country, you guys. So I hope you guys understand if I'm just a little bit out right now. I hope I'm not though. I'm like, that would be so unprofessional. But anyway, so I'm just gonna be placing some roofs over here. Actually, you know what? Let me just place these ones as well over there on the center. I mean, on the corners, actually. And where it makes some very, very interesting details to the house as well. And we are gonna see more of that detail when we get into, like, the detail of the roofs and stuff like that. It's really, really interesting, you guys. But anyway, the roof is gonna be attached like that. I guess it's gonna avoid that one column, I guess, and then it's gonna just extend like that. Really, really complicated roofing we have here. And then over, oh my god, yep, very complicated actually. Let's do that. Let's do that, and then extend it over here. Well, the drag and drop mechanic in The Sims 4 actually kind of works well, you know, with my building style. And I'm not so sure. I feel like it's gonna be really difficult for newbie simmers, though. I'm not so sure. This probably makes it easier for them, but I'm honestly like not sure. But anyway, it's gonna be like that. You know what? Maybe we can make it a little bit higher. 1, 2. Yep, I like the pitch of that, so let's keep it like that. And then this one can be also erased as well. 1, 2. I'm being very careful here, you guys. I'm just really iffy about these types of things. I think I'm just a perfectionist, you know. Nothing wrong with being a perfectionist, so. 1, 2. And I think you guys actually like my precision, you know. You know, for me, everything is quantified, everything is measured and all that stuff. So, you know, I think buildings are just much more better like that. I do hope that we have a fence though that can cover. This one looks really interesting, actually. Do you guys hear that? That was like probably a bus or I don't know, or like some public transportation. I don't know. You know what? Let's use some other. Maybe this one. Well, I'm glad that it comes in a black, so yay. That's nice. It looks really weird though. You know what? I feel like I'm just gonna go with this one. If it comes. Oh, nice. I like how it comes in a brick. You guys saw that? It comes in a nice brick color. I really like that. So basically, the servants' quarters is gonna be filled with ashes and cinders, and it's gonna be black, you know, which kind of reflects their miserable lifestyle. I love that. I love it. Very, very Les Miserables type of drama here happening. But anyway, I guess that's gonna be it for that area. Okay, what else do we need to do? We need to do some details for the roof, actually. And I also think that I need to place, like, some sort of foundation over here as well. Let's see here. Like that, I guess. And, of course, we can just get rid of... I want to get rid of the fence first, actually. Last night, we actually watched Grave Encounters. Really good, you guys. I mean, it scared the crap out of me. I literally like, can we please stop? You know, I had two of my friends stay the night, and then we watched freaking Grave Encounters. It was really, really good. We watched Grave Encounters 1, and we also watched the sequel of it, so it's really, really awesome as well. I feel like I want to watch it with my brother though, so maybe after I do this recording while the video is rendering, I'm probably gonna watch it with my brother. Just some really, really nice horror movies to watch with friends and, you know, scare the crap out of us in a stormy night. Literally though, you guys, the wind was so strong, 200 kilometers per hour usually is how fast they reach. And I know, because I'm an architect, I study those types of things and stuff like that. Well, I'm an aspiring architect, but anyway. So that's gonna be the nice little patio that we have on the side. It does look a little bit weird. You know what? I feel like I want to add another patio out back, actually. What do you guys think? I'm not so sure. We're probably gonna be figuring that out over the next couple of parts. I'm not so sure, because I do want this to feel like a courtyard, but I don't know if the Sims can actually, I don't think they can. If I place a door here, I don't think the Sims can pass by it and stuff like that. But anyway, we'll figure it out. So for downtown, it actually has a nice little wall area over here like that, I guess. I don't know, it kind of works like that. Maybe if we look for other... Oh, now I'm disappointed. I was like, please come in our colors. Does this one come in our colors? Yeah, well, it does come, so... Well, come in our colors. So I'm just gonna use it like that, I guess. Or maybe even like that. Is that like too... You know what, let's just... make it like this one. And we also just finished watching freaking Scream, you guys, with freaking Drew Barrymore and Matthew Lillard, who played Shaggy and Scooby-Doo. I'm like, holy crap. And I feel like we need to put, like, one of these things or something. I don't know. Let's put this and let's make it that. Just that. I sounded like freaking retarded back there, but anyway, let's put it in that color, I guess. You know what? No, let's put it over there so that it would like frame the other fence that I'm gonna be placing. Yeah, that works well, I guess. What do you guys think? The color of it kind of feels a little bit off though. And then this one looks too eggy or something. I don't know. What do you guys think? You know what? I'm gonna go with that for now. And let's just look for a nice little fence that comes in our colors. This one, it looks like something that you would put inside. This one, yes. Oh my god. And of course, it does not come in our colors. This one probably, yeah. That's nice, I guess. It reminds me of something you would put inside, though. Maybe this one? Yeah, I like that. I like that a lot. So, yep. Oh my god, you guys. I actually really like how it looks now. I'm like, what? Yes, yes, yes. Please. Yes, it looks lovely. I like it a lot. And I'm really happy. Oh, I'm so happy with how it looks so far. Let me just put a trim over here, actually. Maybe like that. And then let's just place another type of fence. Or you know what, let's place, if you guys heard that, that was the freaking train outside my window. I'm like, it always likes to make noise every time I'm making these videos for you guys. But anyway, let's do that. And I guess we can just replace the fence. Like that-ish. Oh, it like, ooh, what did it do? What did it do to our wall? I'm like, whoa. Anyway, I'm like just gonna do that, I guess. Oh, that's nice. I like that. This is kind of like the main entrance to downtown, so the main door is gonna be there. I totally forgot to place like the main door though, so we're gonna do that. It's just a nice wooden door, you know, nice wooden door. Nothing special to it, you know. I think the house is so freaking special that you don't need so much pizzazz. Anyway, I hope I can place it though. Let's see here. Let's just look for them. And it's puny. The door is so small. Don't we have like some taller doors? This one, it doesn't come in our colors, you guys. Oh my god, are you freaking kidding me? Let's see here, does any of these come in our colors? I don't necessarily want it to be. What do you guys think of that? That looks weird. Oh my god, I feel like I should just go with that for now. You know, why not? It may not be 100% what they have in real life, but I guess it kind of works. You know, it does work, I guess, and yeah. Okay, somebody just texted me, so anyway, ignore that. Sorry for that long pause, you guys. Okay, anyway, like I was saying, there's just some really interesting details over here as well happening with this corner here, so it's also quite interesting. So let's do that like that, and then over here as well, I guess it makes it look like it's turrets, you know, similarly to what you would normally have in castles and all that stuff. Really, really interesting detail, actually. It says a lot about the architect because, you know, it takes some time, it takes a while to, you know, execute the details that you put in the buildings and stuff, and especially planning it out and making sure that it works well with all the other designs in the house, and also making sure that the house functions. There's a lot of things to consider. So being an architect is not easy, but it's definitely fulfilling. And you know, it's definitely my goal in the future is to become a successful architect. And I'm just really happy that a lot of you guys actually do support my journey into becoming an architect. You know, I've gotten a lot of encouragement from you guys that, you know, just a lot of good lucks and good jobs and all that stuff. I'm just really, really thankful that I was able to be part of YouTube and that I'm able to contribute something to the Sims community. And I hope that you guys will continue. I'm being very dramatic here. And I hope that you guys will continue to support me and, you know, help me grow my channel so that it would reach more and more people. Because I think at the end of the day, it's not about how many subscribers I get. It's really about the relationship that I develop with you guys. And, you know, as much as possible, I try my best to reply to each and every one of your guys' comments. And, you know, of course, I do block some people from my channel. You know, I guess this would be a good time to like bring that up. If you're in my channel and if you're like harassing people, or if you're harassing me, if you're just commenting like some random bullshit, then please don't. Because if you do, you will never be able to be coming back to my channel, because I will block you without giving it a second thought. You know, pacifist here, you guys. I mean, yeah. But anyway, so far I was only able to block like 4 people, so hopefully none of you guys are like upset about people commenting negatively and stuff like that. So yeah, but don't worry if you have negative comments, you know, about The Sims 4 or The Sims 3 or whatever. Those are your opinions, and I totally welcome those, and I actually welcome those on my channel. The comments that I don't like are the ones that kind of like insults people, you know, especially the ones that insult my viewers and just, you know, makes them feel bad and stuff like that. Just don't even bother. So yeah, anyway, that was like a threat, but anyway, everyone is welcome on my channel as long as they act appropriately is what I'm trying to say. But anyway, I'm gonna keep it like that. And you guys can see that we actually lost, like, the other... If I control Z, it's gonna come back, see? Which is really weird, I don't understand what's going on. I'm like, see? It's like, you guys get what I mean? It's like, if I keep it like that, we have, like, those fence posts. If I don't, we lose one fence post. And it just makes the house look really weird and bizarre, but anyway. So yep, that's how it's gonna look like. Let's see here, what else do we need to do? Okay, we need to add some more detail to these turrets. Anyway, you guys, I do think that, let's see here, I actually don't like how the kitchen is over here, so I think I'm actually just gonna move that somewhere on this side, maybe. You know what, let's do that, and let's actually extend this hallway so that it can have like another exit over here somewhere. And then let's see here, since I extended that, we can extend these ones as well, getting rid of the space in the middle. And then let's like do that, and okay, wait a second. Yep, like that. So probably this is gonna be the kitchen, and then somewhere here is gonna be the servant's dining room. And also this is probably gonna be Mrs. Hughes' office or something, I don't know, or Mr. Carson's office, I don't know. And I don't know, maybe even like a toilet or something. And actually we need to get rid of these. We need to get rid of these, actually, those. So this can be just one whole room. And let's see here. I feel like I need to, like, put another waiting room or something over here. So let's do that there. And I guess we can split it into two, you know? One of these can probably be, like, the waiting room. The other one can be, like, the other one can be probably like, I don't know, a powder room or something like that. And anyway, since the staircase is actually gonna be attached on this side, I don't think we need those windows. So let's see here. I'm not so sure if I'm gonna keep the paint like that. You know what, let's not. Let's just make it one solid color like that, which I think it's a little bit better. And if I actually put these ones over there, what do you guys think? I think that would look a little bit better. I'm not so sure though. Yeah, I really do like how it looks though, so I think I'm gonna keep that. I'm not so sure. The only concern I have is probably making the house look like too overly designed and too overly decorated. I do not want that for my buildings, you know. As much as possible, I want my homes to be effortless, you know. I don't want them to try hard. I want them to be not overly designed, because, you know, if you design, if you overly design your home, you'll end up with something that's like a mishmash or something, you know? You guys get what I mean? You'll end up with something that's pretty much like really, really slow when it comes to functioning, or when it comes to its functionality in the game, because you're adding so much stuff. So, you know, really minimizing what you put in your homes really, really helps, especially in terms of making a downloadable content. You know, many people actually don't have powerful computers like myself, so, you know, the lighter something is, the better it is, just the more practical it is to download, I guess. But anyway, I'm rambling here, you guys, but I am really happy with how the servants' quarters is turning out to be. Let's see here. So I think what we need to do is just place these over here, I guess, to pretty much make a nice little turret, I guess, or something like that, or tower, I guess, to make the house look all beautiful and stuff like that. Very, very nice. Let me just place this over here as well, and see how it looks. You know what, seeing it like that, it actually looks like there's like a lot going on. And if you guys hear that wind going on outside my window, it's like literally, though, you guys, 180 kilometers per hour or something like that. But anyway, if I put that there, what do you guys think? Does that look good at all? I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that. Over here, though, I think, well, I think I like it for the central tower. I'm not so sure, though, for the rest of the four towers, what we're gonna do. Just because, yeah, I like it for the central one. For these ones, though, I feel like I'm just gonna be Now, let's demolish all the fences that we have. Let's see here. And maybe we're just gonna place these ones, I guess. Mega fence. And then let's do that. And then we can place the open one in the middle, I think would be better, like that, I guess. What do you guys think? I think that's so much better, though. Yeah, I think that is so much better. Oh my god, you guys. Oh my freaking god, it actually looks legit like Downton Abbey now. I'm like, whoa. I'm like, yes. I'm really happy with how it looks, pretty much. I do want to place, like, a platform over here, just so that we can place a door as well on that side. Let's see here, probably like, oh my god, I can't drag it, I guess maybe like that, so it kind of lines up with the hallway. And then another one over here. I hope it doesn't remove these columns and stuff. I don't think they are, though. I think like that, probably, even though the real Downton Abbey probably doesn't have, well, I'm sure it doesn't have something like this, though. So not so sure if I should even keep it like that. What do you guys think? I'm not sure, but for now I feel like I want to keep it, you know. Let's just delete that. We'll figure it out in the next part, probably, for all these foundation things. I'm not so sure. I'm just really not sure. I'm like, I don't want to decide. I don't want to force myself to decide just because, you know, I'm a little bit stressed for time right now. But I do hope this video is about an hour long. I don't want to go over an hour and 30 minutes. I think that's just more than a movie. But I do want to let you guys know that I'm enjoying so much talking to you guys. And I don't know. I talk to myself sometimes, you know. I ask myself questions. I don't know. I'm probably like making myself sound really weird, but whatever. Let's just do the exact same thing that we did on the other tower, I guess. Oh, and I completely forgot that one didn't have a window on one side. So yeah, and let's see here. And then one over here as well, and then over here as well. Just very, very repetitive, you know. It's very typical of classical architecture to be, you know, to be repetitive. I think that's one of the trademarks that I actually really like about old buildings, is that they're very iconic, I guess, and all that stuff. I don't know, I just really like that aspect of them. And I totally forgot that we need to put this one as well over here out back. Where is that? Okay, there. It's called the Spanish Revival Wall, by the way. Really, really nice name. And we can use it like that. Fantastic. Maybe we can even actually like play some of these Buenaventura columns. Very nice name, actually. A lot of these are actually very Hispanic, you know, the names of these homes and just a lot of the detail. It reminds me a lot of Espanol, you know, you guys. And let me just put that there as well. It's giving me a hard time to place. Okay, like that, I guess. What do you guys think? Yeah, I like it. I like it like that. It looks nice. Okay, one thing that I also want to do is add a roof over here. Just because it looks too bare for me. You know, it looks like it's such a large space not to be covered by a roof. And at least, you know, if we put a roof now, if in the future we have the Sims 4 season, so you guys don't have to worry about your Sims getting wet or your Sims getting cold in the snow. So yeah, that's really cool. And the last thing that I want to do is place some of these nice little columns, which are so freaking pretty. I wish it would I wish we would get some that is like in our colors, I guess. Maybe this one. Yeah, it does come in our colors, so like that probably. What do you guys think? It's either that or that. What do you guys think? I kind of like the browner color. I don't know. Which means that I actually am going to replace these fences. I'm just gonna replace them really, really quickly. You guys can always fast forward the video. I'm like, okay, I made a wrong choice, kind of. Because these fences, I think, look so much better than what we have right now. I don't know, just probably me, though. So I'm just gonna replace them really quickly. I'm like, I've said, you guys, earlier, I literally, like, make this up as I go. So, of course, we're gonna have to encounter some really interesting, you know, revisions, I guess, when it comes to my ideas and all that stuff. But I hope you guys, I know you guys understand, you know, building is not permanent, you know. You're free to change whatever you want, and that's a really cool thing. So let me just replace all of these. I should probably be doing these off camera, but since this is like the first ever part of this series, I'm trying to just squeeze in as much as I can. But anyway, I guess while I'm changing these, we can always talk about, you know, Downton Abbey. You know, I can't wait for season 5. You know, it comes out September 20 something, I guess. And I can't wait, you guys. I can't wait, you know, a couple of weeks. Oh my god, you know what? A couple of days from now, we're gonna be seeing freaking Downton Abbey, and I hope I'm gonna have time for it because I'm gonna be really, really busy with school. I'm planning to go on an international trip, you know, with my classmates, probably in London or probably gonna be in Berlin. What do you guys think? Really, really cool, right? I can't wait. It's gonna be my first European trip, and I can't tell you guys enough how much of a dream come true it is for me to go to Europe, you know. Many of my buildings are European inspired, you know. My French buildings are really, really popular, and recently I uploaded a French Petit Channel and also the Italian inspired Villa Capra. So, you know, being able to go to Europe is just an amazing opportunity for me. Really, really expensive though, so I'm not so sure if it pushes through. I hope my parents will be willing to admit, you know, will be willing to fund my exploration of Europe, I guess. But if I do get that opportunity, I will vlog it for you guys, probably without my face because I look freaking ugly. I look fugly, and I'm very, very awkward as well. And I don't want to be filming myself in Europe and where people are gonna judge me, you know. Anyway, he's weird, you know. He's filming himself. He's one of those YouTube geeks, but whatever. Bottom line, I cannot wait to go to freaking Europe, you guys. I just can't. And I will keep you guys posted, I guess. You know, I always have my social media and all that stuff. And I will probably pre-record a lot of the videos that I'm gonna be doing just to keep you guys entertained, I guess, while I'm out. So, now that that's done, I'm just looking what else we need to do? Okay, here we probably need to make like a hole. Like a hole in the for the balcony. You guys will get what I mean. Probably for the next part, I guess. You know, it's gonna be more of the interiors, definitely. So I'm just finishing. Yep, this is gonna be like a balcony. So this room is gonna be 2 floors high. Really, really cool aspect of downtown as well. And then these are gonna be the bedrooms. I'm thinking for now we're probably gonna have 4 bedrooms at least, which is the master bedroom for Cora and what's his name? Robert. Cora and Robert, which are the masters of the house. Mary, which is the eldest daughter. Edith, which is the middle daughter, which is the kind of the bitter one out of all of them. And then I do have a soft spot for Edith, though, I don't know. And also one for probably one for Sybil, even though she passed away. Spoilers, you guys, Sybil died, unfortunately. But I guess we can always put baby Sybil in it, her child, or maybe even Branson, I don't know. Let's see here. I'm thinking, what else? Okay, I was thinking we should put these ones and change it, the color. Okay, that matches. So that's awesome. And it looks freaking amazing, you guys. Reminds me of like Hampton Court or something. Probably a palace that, I don't know, maybe Henry VIII would own. You know, these turret things were really popular during the Tudor times, I guess. Because I watched a lot of documentaries and I'm freaking obsessed, you guys. Just so you guys, if you guys probably don't know, I'm freaking obsessed here. And really, really interesting with the columns in The Sims 4. You guys can see if I actually place it in the corner of a fence, it deletes the fence post, which I really like. I really like the effect of it. And I don't know, it just looks awesome, I guess. And like that as well. I'm thinking of also placing some chimneys or something. I don't know though. I don't know how to work chimneys in, but if you guys can see, the house looks freaking amazing. It looks a lot like Downton actually, which makes me so happy that I'm finally gonna be able to make a Downton family and probably even create a Let's Play out of this. If you guys don't know, my house, my rules, my Sims, he actually is currently doing a Downton Abbey Sims 3 challenge. So he is a very nice person. The two of us have been commenting on each other's videos, so I hope that you guys will be also checking out his channel as well. So let's see here, what else do I need to do? I'm just making checks here. I guess I can always just make a floor plan of this area, and or maybe just even get a really basic idea of what I'm gonna work with for the next part, you know, like that, I guess. Or yeah, this is probably gonna be a hallway that connects all the different bedrooms and all that stuff. So okay, is that already 2x2? Yeah, no, it's not. Like that. And you guys probably noticed me not placing windows and floors, I mean windows and doors over here for the servants' quarters. That's because I'm really like not sure how it's gonna look as of now. I'm just really not so sure how I want it to look, you know, or maybe even just, oops, I accidentally moved my frame there. Okay, there we go. I think you guys saw a little bit of my desktop or something. I don't know. I'm still moving it. Anyway, let's see here. Whoops. Okay, there we go. Anyway, let's see here for the servants' quarters. I'm not so sure if I'm even gonna keep that roof, but for now, I think I'm gonna keep it. And Downton, I totally forgot the color of the roof of it, but I guess to wrap up this part, let's just put some materials for the roof, I guess. I do like how this one looks. So maybe we're gonna be, if it was gray, that would have been so much more better. So much better. Much more better. I'm not so sure how you phrase it in English properly, but let's see here. Maybe even black. What do you guys think of that? I don't know. That looked too severe for me. And this one, okay, maybe just that one, I guess. It's probably the same roof I used for the Trianon. But anyway, we'll figure it out in the next part. So you know what, guys? I think we can even paint this one. Oh my god, we can even paint the floor. That is so freaking cool. That is actually really cool. I'm like just whoa right now. I'm pleasantly surprised that we can do it. So we're gonna do that. Then put that there as well. Really, really cool, actually. I'm like pleasantly surprised that we can do it. I'm just wild right now. But you know what, guys? I think, you know what? Probably gonna be it for this video. Let me just do a quick rundown on it. If you guys noticed, this was where we built the Trianon Palace, and I demolished it because I knew that it was gonna, you know, steal the attention away from Downton, and I want all the attention for this video to be focused on Downton Abbey itself. So you know what, guys? I think I'm gonna end this part right here. I hope you guys enjoyed this very first part in this Let's Build The Sims 4 Downton Abbey, I guess, or the Sims 4 House Building Downton Abbey series, which will probably run for about 5 to 6 parts. If it's longer, I don't know at this point, but I hope you guys enjoyed. As usual, please like, favorite, and subscribe, because it really does help us out a lot. I'm sorry if I'm like all over the place today. I don't know, there's a typhoon. So anyway, I just want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Freezer Bunny. You all have an awesome day, and I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye!